Well, let's see. We are now on week 18, day one. Wow, it's hard to imagine that we've already gotten through one third of our Bible reading for the year. That's just incredible. And I think we really need to pat ourselves on the back for sticking with it. And for those of you who didn't start at the beginning of the year with us, thanks for joining in. Reading God's word is just so valuable and so important. And so today we are looking at 2 Samuel chapter 7, 1 Chronicles chapter 17, and then a collection of Psalms, Psalms 1, 2, 33, 127, and 132. Now, I know that seems like a lot of reading, but the Psalms this day are pretty short. Well, we have also reached a pivotal moment in the history and the story of the biblical narrative. David's kingdom is firmly established. He's no longer on the run from Saul. Saul has passed away. The people of Israel have accepted David as their king. He has worked tirelessly to bring about a glorious golden age, as it will be known. He's moved the capital to Jerusalem, and he finds himself in a state of contemplation. Basically, he's at a point where he acknowledges he lives in this beautiful palace made of cedar, and yet God still lives in a tent, the tabernacle. And so he longs to build a temple for God. The prophet Nathan, as an advisor to him, says, "Go for it. You know, God has been behind you in everything." And in today's reading, we see that God then comes to Nathan in the night in dreams and says, "No, it's not David's place to build me a temple." God reminds David through Nathan that God doesn't need a temple. God needs nothing from us. What God wants from us is our love and devotion, a relationship of respect. And God also reminds David through Nathan and us that David is not the star of the story, believe it or not. God is the central figure in the story of Scripture. But nonetheless, God also identifies with David as someone who has great respect for God, who loves God, who has lived a life as a man after God's own heart. And so in this passage, we also see that God makes yet another covenant, this time with David and all of his line, that they shall be an enduring kingdom in Israel forever. Now, if you have read the Bible before, you've heard the stories, we know that that doesn't seem to hold fast. But the truth of the matter is that ultimately it does. Jesus, who is a descendant of David, ultimately is the King of Kings. And so he will fulfill this covenant that God makes with David, that David's line will ultimately always be on the throne in God's kingdom. In fact, the Psalms accent various themes that God makes, that God promises to David as part of this covenant. And so I hope that you will read those in line with the covenant that God makes with David and that ultimately God makes with us. There will always be a human king on the throne, but it will be the God incarnate, God in flesh, our Savior, Jesus Christ.